Welcome to F1 World, a journey through the sport that'll offer you events based around casual or competitive play, single player or multiplayer, fun versus realism, and everything in between. As you play, you'll earn upgrades that can be equipped to your car and team in the garage, increasing your tech level and giving you the performance you need to tackle greater challenges. Along the way, you'll build up your compendium, find new ways to customise your car and character, earn trophies for your trophy cabinet and more. So when you're ready, jump into the play screen and take your first steps into F1 World.
I need a moment.
This is your garage. As you play F1 World, you'll earn upgrades, which can be equipped here to improve your tech level. Upgrades are split into car parts and team members. Team members require a contract in order to be equipped. As well as improving your tech level, upgrades also confer gameplay mods that change how your car and team perform on track. Okay, new items you've acquired appear here. So we've got some, so let's go and open them and see what you got. This is what we call the activity screen. It's basically your jumping off point for all the different ways you can play F1 World. Okay, so feel free to explore, have a good look around, and when you are ready to get your journey going, just select series from the list and we'll go from there.
Welcome along, everybody, to our latest F1 World event. There might just be a single prize for victory, but there are so many stories up and down the grid as our drivers look to make a name for themselves. It's the first year for Vegas on the Formula One calendar and the first year in F1 world as well. Elvis might have left the building, but who will come through the door and make themselves a hero tonight? Now, Anthony Davidson, take me back to when you first made your debut and give us some practical advice today for our F1 world debutant.
Well, yeah, I mean, Crofty, it can be an intimidating time, definitely rocking up for your first big event like that. But you've got to have faith in your own abilities and have faith in the practice that you've put in at this point. And, you know, I would say above anything else, just go out there and enjoy it and try to finish unscathed as well. Easier said than done when it's your first big competition. Just keep your nose clean and get through to the end. That's the best advice I can give.
Okay, pull the clutch in, hold it there until the start. Let's build the revs up and hold them. That was a nasty hit. Turn the engine off and wait for the marshals.
A nearly flawless performance here then, and a commanding victory. Tell me, Ant, how do they manage to achieve this win? Welcome then. We've got wheel to wheel, we've seen thrills and spills. Who knows what's coming?
Welcome to the series screen. Each series of events has objectives that can award you items such as upgrades and resources that can be used to improve your tech level. Completing a series can unlock further series, exploring more and more of the world of Formula One.
welcome along, ladies and gentlemen, to our latest F1 World event. And as our drivers line up on... Team effort then to secure victory here in the Styrian Alps. Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
The faces on our top three look so incredibly happy as they make their way up to the podium. A much-deserved victory and a brilliant performance from them all. That the action comes thick and fast in F1 World. I can't wait for the next time.
Nice one, you've just earned an upgrade. Upgrades can be equipped to your F1 World car and will increase your tech level. The higher your tech level, the more events you'll be able to take on, so it's important to equip upgrades whenever you can. Upgrades can be equipped in the garage, so it's worth going there now to equip your new upgrade. Ranked is F123's competitive multiplayer arena, where players compete each week to move up. When you're equipping a new team member, you need to provide them with a contract. Each contract bestows a bonus mod upon that team member and lasts for a fixed number of events. Note that if you replace a team member or their current contract is destroyed, no matter how many events were left on it.
the home of the Formula One World Championship. It's where it all began in 1950, and it's my favourite track on the calendar. But what do our drivers feel about Silverstone? Well, for a start, they'll know there's plenty of overtaking opportunities, so they won't be despairing. Anthony...
really enjoy...
A show-stopping... So many stories. Who knows what the next chapter has in store for us all? So join... And as our drivers...
Okay, here we go. I'm available.
Performance on the track today, a well-deserved victory. Tell me, Ant,
they were able to deliver such an incredible result today.
I really feel the track layout combined with the track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
Here comes your top three making their way down to the podium for what can only be described as a fantastic day for Formula One. Today is there for all to see, but next time, who knows who might be standing on top of that podium. Join us again next time for more thrilling F1 World action.
This icon means that it's a licensed event. Licensed events offer different experiences based on your chosen license level. Respectful driving grants access to higher license levels, but incurring warnings and penalties will limit the range of licenses you can use. You can choose which license to drive under from those you have access to. Driving under higher level licenses will deliver a more authentic F1 experience. There are bonuses and benefits to driving under a higher license level. So to progress efficiently in F1 world, it's worth trying to gain a higher license.
Welcome, everybody. It's not where you start, it's where you... So it's time to bring out your crystal ball, Natalie Pink.
car.
Okay, so there's plenty we can work on after today. We got ourselves in all sorts of trouble and we didn't hit our target.
A great race then. Well, what? Today will surely, no doubt, come back to excite us once more. These drivers can...
completing event objectives is a great way to earn extra reward. Events refresh regularly, so be sure to check back.
Mercedes moved to the top of the table. Tell me, Ant, how do they manage to achieve this win?
Let's move on to the constructors.
It was a tough race at times, but they've held on to take a great victory for McLaren today.
Et si nous parlions de Ferrari?
Anthony Davidson is here once again for today's Grand Prix.
first things first. Let's create your driver. Let's focus on your driver's look. Great, that's everything we need. You can go back and edit anything we've done so far, and we'll come back here at the start of each season. Or if you're ready to go, hit advance to head to Team HQ, and we can start our push to the top of Formula One.
Done millions of miles in the simulator pre-season, but this is where we get the real data from the real car on the real racetrack. So as many miles as you can get done consistently over these sessions, the happier we're going to be. There'll be a lack of rubber out on track, so take it easy for the first couple of laps. just want to remind you to keep an eye on your tyre temperatures, which you can do on the temperature panel of the MFD. You monitor carcass temperature and surface temperature. You'll get the best performance when they're both inside a normal operating window. Surface temps tend to fluctuate faster, so try a few laps with the data open and get a feel for how to control them. stopping this lap. D. You got a lot of valuable information out of that. Well done. Okay, we can take you this lap. Please, cars ready to leave.
interesting practice session there, then let's remind ourselves of the top three, which are
Adams, Williams, Amory, Cordeel.
Practice times are on the board then, but no points are on offer just yet. We'll be back with more F2 action soon.
Set for the race tomorrow, but before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, which are
Adams, Cordeel, and Marino Sato.
The grid is set then, and that just leaves the race itself. Join us tomorrow where we'll be live with all the action. Till then, goodbye.
Welcome to Sakhir and the Bahrain International Circuit, where the grid is forming up ready for today's race. plenty of opportunities around the 3.36 miles of the Bahrain International Circuit for these young F2 drivers to show what they can do. The best passing opportunity right up there at Turn 1, and we should see plenty of action there. But there's another not long after at Turn 4. There are 9 right-handers and 6 left-handers, and the possibility that we could see some flat spots at the tightest of those left-handers, that's Turn 10. We are nearly ready for the start of today's race, but in the meantime, let's take a look at the grid. Adams lines up on pole position, with Amaury Cordiel alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Sarto, Fittipaldi, Jayan Deruvala, Novalak, Phipps, Porcher, Awasa, Callum Williams, Vesti, Lawson, Richard Vershaw, Dennis Hauger, Doohan, Drugovich, Calderon, Logan Sargeant, Nissany, Hughes, Boshong, and Ollie Caldwell completes the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track. As we await the start of another hugely anticipated Formula 2 race, I'm joined again by Davide Valsecchi. Davide, as a former GP2 champion, can we get some insight to what is running through these young drivers' heads as they sit out on the grid?
Ciao Alex, it's a pleasure to be here. They are nervy moments, there is no doubts about that. Mental strength is the key to remaining calm and focusing on the upcoming race. Formula 2 is so competitive, and all of these drivers know that they are going to be pushing each other all of the way. In these sports, you have to be able to control your nerves.
Okay, we celebrated pole position yesterday. That's history now. Today, we go for the win. I want to be celebrating with you at the end of this race. Come on, mate. Bright is good, gearbox is responding normally. Make sure to warm up the tyres and brakes. Warm the tyres and brakes throughout the lap, please. Make sure we get the edge on the surrounding drivers as the lights go out. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with the clutch. stop today. One stop left in this strategy. Your pit window is going to open in 3 laps time. Pit window opens in 3 laps. We're approaching the pit window now, and you're going to be on hards next time. Yuri's in the pits. Yuri is in the pits. Our teammate by 19.4 seconds. superb driving. That is the race win, my friend. Well done.
Brilliant stuff from High Tech GP today. What a superb victory. And I have to wonder, Davide Valsecchi, just what set them apart from the competition here?
The difference was in the strategy. Maybe to the driver, for sure. But races like this really drive home how much of a team sport this is. They did a lot of work on the pit wall to really make the most of each stint and to make the best use of the tires. But that said, all of that would have been for nothing without a talented hand on the wheel.
And as they make their way down to the podium, there's no denying the strength of the High Tech GP team. It was an incredible performance today, and they fully deserve to stand on the top step. Increases their championship lead. And now, Davide Valsecchi, let me ask you, who is your driver of the day?
I'd probably go for Olly Caldwell. The team did a good job with the strategy to put him in the pit, and he was good enough to take the opportunities.
And here's how things are shaping up in the team's championship. High Tech GP moved to the top of the table. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.
Don't push the car just yet. Track is still green. Try to take it easy for the first couple of laps. on, so come on back to the garage and I can take you through the numbers. Engines fired up, we're set. safe for now, so return to the garage as soon as you can. Confirmed, we'll receive you at the end of this lap.
cars are now over the line. Your top three again are Adams, Cordier, Dennis Hauger. That concludes an interesting practice session. Let's hope for more excitement as the weekend unfolds. Down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. Adams, Owasso, and Teo Porcher. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the feature race gets itself underway. Greetings and welcome to Jeddah for what promises to be a thrilling Formula 2 race. So let's examine the Jeddah Street Circuit, as you can see, this has the potential to be a very challenging track for our young F2 drivers. We'll get a good chance to see which of them have been able to best capitalise on their time spent here in practice earlier this weekend. Like the other street circuits on the calendar, the lack of runoff is going to make sections of this track very punishing if the drivers get it wrong. Let's hope we avoid having to bring out the safety car this time around. Let's look at the grid order for today's race while the cars make their final preparations. Adams lines up on pole position, and it's Ayumu Owasa in P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Porcher, Cordier, Felipe Dragovic, and Pashaw. Fittipaldi, Novalak, Hauger, Jayan Deruvala, Phipps, Dewan, Callum Williams, Ollie Caldwell, Vesti, Lawson, Sato, and Ralph Boschong. Sargeant, Nissani, Hughes, and Tatiana Calderon completes the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. As we await the start of another hugely anticipated Formula 2 race, I'm joined again by Davide Valsecchi. Davide, as a former GP2 champion, can we get some insight to what is running through these young drivers' heads as they sit out on the grid?
Ciao Alex, it's a pleasure to be here. There are nervy moments, there is no doubt about that. Mental strength is the key to remaining calm and focusing on the upcoming race. Formula 2 is so competitive, and all of these drivers know that they are going to be pushing each other all of the way. In these sports, you have to be able to control your nerves.
Okay, we've got that relief of having points on the board finally, so let's keep that form up and get another top 10 finish today, please. Okay, so let's go through all the gears if you can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool though, so don't go too high with the revs. Okay, good parking there, mate. Now we need to make sure we get a great launch as the race starts. Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up now. Be patient and watch for those lights. gap to your teammate behind is 23.1 seconds. superb driving. That is the race win, my friend. Well done.
It was touch and go for a while there, but High Tech GP have done it. A great win. Tell me, Davide, what was the key to this success?
It was down to one thing: consistent pace over everyone else out there on the track. We could spend a good deal of time talking about race and driver strategy, what has occurred on the track. But at the end of the day, the difference here was down to simply being faster on track than everyone else. Amazing skill on show.
And it's time now for the podium celebrations, and how well deserved is this one? What a fantastic victory for High Tech GP. See how this result affects the driver's championship. Adams increases their championship lead. And so, driver of the day then, Davide Valsecchi, who do you think you'd go for?
I'd probably go for Dennis Auger. The team did a good job with the strategy to put him in the pack, and he was good enough to take the opportunities.
And now a look at the team standings. High Tech GP moved to the top of the table. Another team that excelled today was Dams, who make further progress up the table. There will be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you'll join us at the next race when Formula 2 returns.
get used to this. Woohoo! Lick the stamp and sense it. Guys, thank you so much. You've been great all weekend.